Welcome to the Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox component tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox component. This component lets you showcase drop-down items in a detailed table-like format with multiple columns, providing more information than standard drop-down lists. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application and provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project and have selected the auto render mode for both server and WebAssembly apps under the Interactive Render Mode section. Apart from this, there are four other modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now the application is ready to use. Next, I'll show you how to add the Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So let me open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox package, and install it. Also, I install the Themes NuGet package to host the CSS and script files. After installation, let me navigate to the Imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox namespace to use the component within the Pages folder. Next, I open the client-side program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox component. Also, ensure that the Syncfusion service is registered in the server-side program CS file. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component, host the script, and refer to the CSS for the component. Here, everything is configured. So, open the Home Razor component, remove the default code, and define the Syncfusion MultiColumn ComboBox component, which allows for displaying multiple columns of data in a dropdown. Then, I set the TItem property, which specifies the data type of the items to be displayed in the ComboBox. Here I set the data type as string, meaning the list contains strings as items. I also set the tValue property to string, defining the data type of the value selected from the combo box. Next, I set the placeholder property with the value select a product, which will be displayed in the component as description. Now let's run the example application. You can see the MultiColumn ComboBox is rendered with the provided placeholder. Next, I will show you how to bind a data source and map fields in the Blazor MultiColumn ComboBox component. First, I add a code block. Here, I create a class named Product. Inside this class, I include several properties like product name, price, availability, category, and rating. Next, I create a list of type product named product list, which holds all the product data to be displayed in the combo box. Then I create the override method named onInitializedAsync, which runs when the component is being initialized. This method is commonly used to set up data or perform actions before the UI is displayed. Inside the method, I create a new list of product class and assign it to the product list. Each product has a product name, price, availability, category, and rating. This list of products is displayed in the combo box. Then I call the base class onInitializedAsync method to ensure any additional initialization logic in the parent class is executed. Finally, I need to bind this list. Before proceeding, I remove the tItem and tValue properties as they are no longer needed. Then I set the data source property to bind it to the product list. Next, if you want to display the product name initially, I create a private variable named selectedProductName, which stores the name of the currently selected product in the combo box. In this case, I set it to tablets, so tablets is selected when the component first loads. Next, I set the bind value attribute and bind it to the selected product name property. This attribute allows dynamic updates to the selected value. When I select an item from the combo box, its name is assigned to this property. Then I set the value field property, which defines the column's data to be displayed as the value for each item in the drop-down list. In this case, I use the product name field as the value. I also set the text field property to product name. This property is useful for showing a meaningful text representation of each item based on a specific column from the data source. Now let's run the application. You can see the product name, tablets, is displayed initially in the multi-column combo box. When I open the drop-down, you will see the provided product list. Upon selecting the smartphone's product, notice that the combo box dynamically updates with the selected value. Next, I will show you how to configure the columns in this component. The multi-column combo box supports auto-generating columns, simplifying the process by automatically creating columns based on the data source. In this case, I demonstrate how to customize the column header text, adjust the column width for optimal display, and set the text alignment to enhance readability. To do this, inside the multi-column combo box tag, define the multi-column combo box column section. Here, I manually configure each column by specifying the data field, width, and text alignment. For example, I set the first column's field to product name with a width of 200 pixel, and its text align property to center the text within the column. I apply the same settings to the price, availability, and category columns, ensuring a uniform width of 200 pixel. I also added the format property in the price column to include the dollar sign and center the text for all the three columns. Look now, when I open the drop-down, you see that the multi-column combo box renders with the customized columns for product name, price, availability, and category. The data is aligned in a neat, structured format, and you can select any product from the drop-down with ease. Next, if you want to customize the height and width of the pop-up, I adjust the pop-up height and pop-up width properties. For instance, I set the pop-up height property. This ensures that the drop-down opens with the exact height needed, especially if you have a long list of items. Similarly, setting the pop-up width property, it allows me to define the width of the pop-up to display the columns without horizontal scrolling. Additionally, set the width property. This property controls the overall width of the multi-column combo box, adjusting how it fits within your layout. Look now, you can see that the width of the multi-column combo box is adjusted as specified. When I click the drop-down, the pop-up height and width adjust accordingly. This customization ensures that the combo box is displayed properly within its container, aligning well with other UI elements. Now let me summarize. In this video, I showed you how to get started with the Blazor multi-column combo box component, including binding the data source and mapping fields. Additionally, I demonstrated how to configure the columns and customize the pop-up. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor components. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.